Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the digital Chebyshev filter design problem using bilinear transformation. Okay, so already this is the third problem. So already using the bilinear transformation, we solved the two problem. Okay, so that problem is also a university question. One is, you see, in the previous, it's a May 2017 question, design digital Butterworth filter for the specification. Okay, and another one, if h of s is directly given, means how to solve in bilinear transformation, the two problems. So this is also an university question, May 2018 and 13 question. Okay, so if you want to learn that videos, means I will give link in the description box. You can refer it, or in my channel, in the name of discrete time signal processing, as well as the digital signal processing, two separate playlist is there. In that playlist, all videos are available in sequence. Okay, you can learn. Okay, so here you see the question, design a digital Chebyshev filter to satisfy the constraint modulus of h of e power j omega sin between 0.7721 for the frequency omega between 0 to 0.2 pi. Okay, and this magnitude h of e power j omega less than 0.1 for the frequency between 0.5 pi to pi. Okay, using bilinear transformation and assume time t equal to 1 second. So similar to this, similar to this specification, already we solved the second problem. But in that method, the question is digital Butterworth filter design. Okay, so here only the thing that is the frequency. Okay, passband frequency and stopband frequency is different. Okay, here 0.55, 0.75. But here it is different data, 0.25, 0.5. And similarly, this passband and gain and stopband gain is also different, but the method is same. So in previous question, we designed a digital Butterworth filter using bilinear transformation. Here we are going to solve the Chebyshev filter using bilinear transformation. Okay, so first we have to note down the given data. So what are the data given? What is this 0.707? This 0.707 is nothing but 1 divided by square root of 1 plus epsilon square. Okay, so already explained. Okay, I explained in that analog filter transformation in previous problem also. This 0.707 is nothing but 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon square. Similarly, this 0.1. This 0.1 is nothing but 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda square. Okay, and this frequency 0.2 pi, it is a pass band frequency omega p, and this 0.5 pi, it is a stop band frequency omega s. Okay, so here the digital frequency is given. So this four data is given. So omega p is 0.2 pi, omega s is 0.5 pi, 1 by square root of this is 0.707, 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda squared is 0.1. Okay, so these are all the given data. So we are going to, that is already, you know, in the design of IR filter, there is no straight procedure to design digital IR filter. We can use one analog approximation. Here in problem, they mentioned the Chebyshev approximation we have to use. Okay, so first step is to, from the given specification, we have to design one analog Chebyshev filter. So in order to do the analog Chebyshev filter, so already the design of analog Chebyshev filter, 2-3 problems solved in the previous videos. Okay, so you just, I will give link for that video in the description box, or in that playlist, in order, all problems are available. Okay, so in order to design the analog Chebyshev filter, the first step is to, we have to find order of the filter. Okay, n. Then we have to find epsilon, mu, then major and minor axis, then poles we have to find out, then denominator polynomial we have to find out, then numerator, then we have to combine and we have to get the transfer function. Okay, so in order to find the order of the filter, first we needed the pass band frequency and stop band frequency, this omega p and omega s. This w omega, already you know, it is used to mention the digital frequencies. This ohm omega is used to mention the analog frequency. So from the digital frequency, first we have to find the analog frequencies. Okay, and from this 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon square, 1 plus square root of 1 plus lambda square, we have to find out epsilon and lambda also. Okay, so that is the first thing. So you see, So from the given data, you just take 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared is 0.707. 0.707, we may write it as 1 by root 2. So numerator same, so denominator it is also same. So taking square on both sides, we can get 1 plus epsilon squared is equal to 2. Then you rearrange, so we can get epsilon value as a 1. Okay, similarly, 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda squared is equal to 0.5. Similarly, you take square on both sides. Then you take reciprocal, then you rearrange. So we can get the lambda value as a 9.95. Okay, so epsilon and lambda is also we needed in order to find the order of the filter. Okay, and the first step is to we how to find the pre-warping analog frequencies. Okay, that is the analog frequency omega p, omega s, we how to find out from the digital given frequency, this omega p and omega s. Okay, that is a pre-warping analog frequencies. So what is the formula? So you know the formula, the pre-warping analog frequency is 2 by t turn omega p by 2. Okay, so here t given, it's a 1 second. Omega p, okay, in our problem, omega p is given as 0.2 pi. So you simply you substitute, okay, then you find the answer 0.45. Okay, so while calculating this, you must put your calci in radian mode. Okay, so in your calci, first, that is normally the calci is in degree mode. So you just put the calci in radian mode. Here, since we have to put in radian mode means within turn, pi is available. Okay, so within angle, in the angle place, pi is available means that angle, we have to take it as a 180 degree. Okay, so that's why you just type 2 turn of 0.2 pi divided by 2, we can get the 0.65. Okay, similarly, the omega s, we have to calculate as 2 by t turn omega s by 2. So 2 by 1 turn of, what is omega s? 0.5 pi divided by 2. So we can get the answer 2. So the two analog frequencies, pass band frequency and stop band frequency calculated. Okay, what is the next step? Next step, we have to find the order of the filter. Okay, so you know this is the Chebyshev filter. Okay, so you know the procedure in order to design the Chebyshev filter. So that procedure we have to follow already, the procedure and related with that, the 2-3 problems we solved previously. Okay, previous video, you just check in that discrete time signal processing playlist or digital signal processing playlist, you check. So previously I posted the analog Chebyshev filter design and analog Butterworth filter design in detail. Okay, so in that the formula for the Chebyshev filter is n is greater than or equal to cos h inverse of lambda by epsilon divided by cos h inverse of omega s by omega p. This is the formula. So you substitute lambda value, epsilon value, omega s, omega p here. So cos h inverse of 9.95 divided by 2 divided by cos h inverse of what is omega s? 2. What is omega p? 0.65. So you substitute. So you find the answer 1.669. Okay. Then the next step is to we have to round off this n. N is a n, you know, n is a order of the filter. Usually the order is it's a second order, third order, fourth order, and so on. Okay. So that's why you just round this one n value to the next higher integer. So we can get n equal to 2. Okay. Then if n is 2 means that a transfer function must have the two poles. Okay. So in order to find out the pole, first we have to find out A and B value. What is A and B means? It is a minor axis and a major axis of the ellipse. Okay. So already you know in a Chebyshev filter, all poles are located in the shape of ellipse. Okay. So that's why in order to find out the poles, first, we have to find out the minor axis and major axis of that ellipse using the formula. This is the minor axis. This is the major axis. So, A equal to omega p mu to the power 1 by n minus mu to the power minus 1 by n divided by 2. Okay. So, here you substitute omega p value and mu value. So, what is mu? Okay. So, we don't know. We didn't calculate mu now. So first we have to calculate mu. So the mu is nothing related with epsilon. So you see the mu equal to epsilon inverse plus square root of epsilon to the power minus 2 plus 1. So already we derived the epsilon value equal to 1. So you substitute this epsilon value in mu formula. So we can get 2.414. Okay. So you just take calc and follow this calculation. You just do the calculation and you check this answer is correct or not. Okay. So mu we calculated as 2.414. So after calculating mu, we have to substitute in A and B. Okay. Simply you see A is here or minus available in B formula instead of B is available. Okay. That's all. So you substitute the passband frequency and mu value in this two formula. We can get A is 0.295. B is 0.717. Okay, so you know A is a minor axis. So A value is always lesser than B. B is a major axis. So the minor axis and major axis of ellipse is calculated. Okay, so what is the next step in Chebyshev filter design? So using this minor axis and major axis, we have to calculate the poles of Chebyshev filter that lie on the ellipse. Okay, using the formula. So the poles are calculated using the formula sk equal to a cos pi k plus j b sin pi k. Okay, this is the formula where the k ranges from 1 to n. Okay, so for our problem, what is n? N equal to 3. So the k ranges from 1, 2, 3. Okay, that means the three poles. If the order of the filter is 3, means there are three poles. The first pole S1, second pole S2, third pole S3. If the order of the filter is 2, means two poles, S1 and S2. Okay, that is the meaning. So here, so SK equal to A cos pi k plus JB sin pi k for k equal to what is the order? The order is 2. Okay, so not N equal to 3, N equal to 2. So the order of the filter is 2 only. So the K value is 1, 2. Okay. So in order to find out this pole, A, B already we calculated. And another one term is that pi k. Okay, so the angle we have to find out. So what is the formula for that angle mean? So you know the formula, the pi k equal to pi by 2 plus 2k minus 1 divided by 2n into pi. Okay, so here for k equal to 1 and 2. So first to put k equal to 1. So for k equal to 1, we can get one angle. For k equal to 2, we can get another angle. Okay. So pi 1 equal to pi by 2 plus. So you substitute k equal to 1 here. So 2 minus 1 by 2 into n is 2. So 4 pi. So if you are solving, we can get 135 degree. Okay. Where pi is 180 degree. Pi means 190. So pi by 2, it's a 90. Plus pi by 4. So 90 plus this, we can get 135 degree. Similarly, for k equal to 2, the second angle is 225 degree. Okay, this is the standard answer. If n is 2 means the first angle is 135, the second angle is 225. If n is 3 means we can get the remaining 3 angle. Okay, so that we will discuss in next problem. So pi 1, pi 2 calculated. So you substitute a value, b value and pi value in this pole formula. So we can get the poles. So the poles are the first pole, okay, whenever k equal to 1, S1 equal to A cos pi 1 plus JB sin pi 1. So what is A? A is 0.295. Pi is 135 degree plus J into B is 0.717 sine of 135 degree. Okay, so you find the answer. Then we can get the answer is minus 0.2086. plus J 0.507. Okay, this is the first pole. Similarly, the second pole. For second pole, K equal to 2. So S2 equal to A cos pi 2 plus JB sin pi 2. So here only you change the angle cos 225, sin 225. So we can get the another pole minus 0.2086 minus J 0.507. Okay, so already this is the you see, you check this two pole. These two poles are complex conjugate poles. Okay, so already I told in that analog Chebyshev filter design, if n equal to 2 means we can get two pole, the two pole must be complex conjugate. Okay, if n equal to 4 means we can get four pole. In that two poles are complex conjugate, the remaining two poles are complex conjugate. If n equal to 3 means we can get three pole. In that two poles are complex conjugate, one pole is different. Okay, so this is the property of Chebyshev filter. If you get complex conjugate poles, you will not get, means your calculation is wrong. Okay, that is the meaning. This is the important property you should remember in the Chebyshev filter. The two poles must be complex conjugate. So complex conjugate, you know, that is the real part is asset is same. In imaginary part, one is plus j that value, another one is minus j that value. Okay, that is the meaning. So we calculated the two poles. Okay, so after calculating the pole, next step we have to find the denominator polynomial. So the denominator, if you know the pole mean, how can you calculate the denominator polynomial? The denominator polynomial is nothing but the product of the variable s minus the first pole into s minus the second pole. Okay. So s minus, this is the first pole, you substitute, then into s minus the second pole. Okay, so then you just multiply. Okay, so you just expand this formula. This minus you give it to here. Okay, similarly you minus give it to here. Then you multiply each term. So we can get the denominator polynomial as s squared plus 0.4272s plus 3. This is the denominator polynomial d of s. Okay. So if you want to find the transfer function, we need a numerator also. Okay, so the next step, we have to find the numerator of transfer function. So the numerator of transfer function is calculated using the value of n. Okay, so there are two steps there. If n is odd, we have to follow one procedure. If n is even, we have to follow the procedure. So for our problem, n is equal to 2, even. So if order of the filter is even means the numerator is calculated by substituting s equal to 0 in denominator polynomial and we have to divide by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared. Okay. If n is odd means the numerator polynomial is nothing but simply you substitute s equal to 0 in denominator, we can get one answer, that is a numerator polynomial. Okay. So depending upon the value of n, we have to select either any one step. Okay. So here n is even. So numerator polynomial is equal to denominator polynomial. In denominator polynomial, we have to put s equal to 0. That value we have to divide by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared. Okay. So you see, this is the denominator polynomial. If you are substituting s 0, this term 0, this term 0, only we can get 0.3. Okay. Divided by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared. So epsilon value already we are having epsilon equal to 1. Okay, so if you are substituting, so 0.3 by square root of 1 plus 1. So the answer is 0.212. Okay, so numerator calculated, denominator calculated. So therefore, the transfer function of the analog Chebyshev filter, H of s equal to numerator polynomial divided by the denominator polynomial. What is the numerator polynomial? 0.212. What is the denominator polynomial? S squared plus 0.4272s plus 0.3. Okay, so simply you substitute. This is our analog transfer function of Chebyshev filter. Okay, so in the design of digital Chebyshev filter, so the first two steps we completed. Okay, so after getting the analog transfer function, now only we have to use the transformation, bilinear transformation. Okay, so what is the use of bilinear transformation? Bilinear transformation is used to convert the analog filter into the digital filter. Okay, so used to convert the analog filter into corresponding digital filter. So in order to convert analog filter into digital filter in bilinear transformation, what is the step? Simply the step in H of s equation, instead of s, we have to substitute 2 by t, 1 minus z inverse by 1 plus z inverse. Okay, that's all. So in this H of s, you just substitute instead of the variable s, 2 by t, 1 minus z inverse by 1 plus z inverse. Where what is t? In our problem, t, sampling time is given as 1 second. So you simply substitute. So the H of z, digital transfer function is obtained by, in H of s equation, substitute s equal to 2 by t is 1. So 2 into 1 minus z inverse by 1 plus z inverse. Okay. So this is our H of s. So in this H of s, you substitute instead of s, 2 into 1 minus z inverse by 1 plus z inverse, you substitute. Okay, so you substitute and you just take LCM and rearrange. we can get the answer. Okay, so you see, so 0.212 divided by S squared. So 2 into this, the whole squared. So 2 squared 4. So 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse, the whole squared, plus 0.4172 into S value plus 0.3. Okay, then you take LCM. Okay, so here what is the LCM? 1 plus Z inverse, the whole squared is the LCM. So you take, so if you are taking LCM, so that divided by 1 plus Z inverse, the whole squared, it will come to the numerator. So that's why I mentioned. Okay, then you expand all the terms. So after cancelling, we can get one reduced answer. Okay, so this is said to be the transfer function of our digital Chebyshev filter. Okay, so this is the design procedure in order to design the digital Chebyshev filter. Okay, so these are all the methods. So in this way, you have to solve. Okay, so first one, from the given specification, you find out the analog frequency. Okay, since the digital frequency is given here, so we have to find the analog frequency and epsilon value, lambda value. Then using that value, we have to find the pre-warping analog frequency. Then we have to find out order of the filter. That order we have to make round it off. Okay, then we have to find minor and major axis. Okay, after that, we have to find poles. Once you calculated the poles, we have to find denominator polynomial, then numerator polynomial. Then if you are combining, we can get the transfer function of analog filter. Then using bilinear transformation in the place of S, if you are substituting S with 2 by T, 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse means we can get the digital filter transfer function. Okay, so you just expand it, you just reduce it, that is the final answer. Okay, so this question is a November-December 2014 question. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos and please press the bell notification button, then only we can you can get a notification once I am posting the video. Okay, so in the next video, we are going to solve, okay, so for the same specification, we are going to solve the digital Chebyshev and Butterworth filter for the same specification using bilinear transformation. Okay, so previously we derived for different specification, Butterworth bilinear problem we solved, Chebyshev bilinear transformation we solved. Now we are going to see both Chebyshev filter as well as the Butterworth filter design for the same specification using bilinear transformation we are going to solve in the next video. Okay, so this is also one of the important Anna University question, May 2017, and the JNTU 2005 question. Okay, so I will discuss this problem in the next video. Okay, so thank you. If you want to learn all lecture videos related with this subject, digital signal processing or discrete time signal processing, in my channel, there is a separate playlist is there. In that playlist, all videos are available in order from the starting, okay, DFT to this. Okay, so you just learn. We will see in the next video.